This conference will now be recorded.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I was telling you that the most common mistake that we often make in the OET writing section is regarding the past tense. Because when we are writing the letter, may it be a discharge letter, a transfer letter, or a referral letter, we include the past events, the past conditions of the patient in our letter. So the past tense is the only tense of which the maximum use is made while writing the OET letters. So now, amongst these past tenses, the past perfect tense, you should know how to use and where to use. So the past perfect tense is used when there are two past events incorporated in the sentence you're writing in your letter. For example, she had not been able to conceive over the previous 4 months, and as a result, she suffered depression. So there are two events included in this sentence. The first sentence is that she has not been able to conceive over the previous 4 months. The another past tense is that she suffered from depression. So there are two past events. Now we have to recognize as to which past event happened first. Which past event happened past to the later event. So the first past event that occurred was that she was not able to conceive. And later on in the past, she suffered from depression. So the correct order should be that first she could not conceive and then she became depressed. So how can we write this sentence? She had not been able to conceive in the past 4 months, as a result of which she suffered from depression. So here we have made use of the past perfect tense. Let us look at one more example that's over on your screens. At today's when you're describing the patient's condition at a time in the past, that is, the patient found blood in the toilet bowl 2 times. Now this can be written: at today's consultation, Miss Leon reported that there had been blood in the toilet bowl on 2 occasions. Now this is also the past perfect tense. So these are 2 examples that we make use of very much in our OET letters, and these, both of these, incorporate the past perfect tense. Now let us look at some more examples. Now we have some handy hints for you. Hint number one is when there is only one past tense, then do not use past perfect, because past perfect is only used when there are two or more than two past events. And we have to define chronology as to which past event occurred first and which past event occurred later to that. For example, the patient had been feeling unwell last week. Now this is an incorrect sentence. The patient had been feeling unwell last week. This is an incorrect sentence. So what is the correct sentence? The correct sentence is the patient was feeling unwell last week. The patient was feeling unwell last week is the correct version. Another sentence we have: the patient had been feeling unwell last week and was admitted to hospital for observation. Now this is a correct sentence because now we have incorporated 2 past events. First, the patient felt unwell, and then he or she was admitted to hospital. The second hint is that past perfect is often used with the word previous instead of ago. Now this is something that nobody else will tell you, but at Teach You Academy, you will find such hints. Teach You Academy is the only and an exclusive platform which inculcates with such information to all of you. So what is our handy hint too? That past perfect is often used with the word previous instead of ago to demonstrate that you are referring to a time before a particular date in the past, not the date you are writing the letter. Did you see that the event has not occurred on the date on which you are writing the letter, but it has occurred past to it? Now let us look at a few examples. These are some incorrect and correct versions. The first incorrect sentence is, she presented to me on 3rd July 2010 for a regular checkup because she experienced several episodes of heart flutter over the past few weeks. Okay, so our sentence is that she presented to me on 3rd July 2010 for a regular checkup because she experienced several episodes of heart flutter over the past few weeks. Now this is an incorrect sentence. So what is the correct form of it? The correct form is, she presented to me on 3rd July 2010 for a regular checkup because she had experienced several episodes of heart flutter over the previous few weeks. Now there are two events that occurred in the past. The first event that occurred in the past is that she presented to me. The second past event is that she experienced. So there are two past events. So here we will not use simple past, but we will use the past perfect. And the past perfect is, she presented to me on 3rd July 2010 for checkup because she had experienced several episodes of heart flutter over the previous few weeks. All right. Now let us look at one more sentence. And I would ask you to correct this sentence. So let us see as to what our example two is. With this notion, I would like all of you participate in this session. So now I want one of you to unmute yourself. Then please tell me as to whether our second example is wrong and what's wrong with it. So our example is, on review 2 weeks later, the frequency of headache decreased. So can somebody tell me as to what's wrong with this sentence?
Hello.
Hello, Susan.
Yes, I can say that the frequency of headache had decreased because it happened before patient come to me.
Yes. So here we have two past events. The first past event is that on review 2 weeks later, the frequency of headache had decreased. So this should be the correct sentence. Thank you very much, Susan, for your participation. And let us see as to what the correct version should be. On review 2 weeks later, the frequency of headache had decreased. Fine, let us come with another example of ours. And again, I would like one of you to unmute yourself. And I encourage all of you to participate in this session, not just one or two students. We have Gavi, Ramya, Dr. Iron, Salma Begum, and several others here on this platform. So I request all of you to participate actively and answer as to what's wrong with our third example. Our third example is, a review on 25th of April 2010 showed the patient's general health improved and her blood pressure dropped to 140/85 and she lost 4 kilograms. So I want one of you to unmute yourself and let us know as to what's wrong with this sentence and what the correct sentence should look like.
Hi, Manu sir.
Hello, I'm sorry, I'm not able to get your name. But very good morning to you. Please reply.
I'm Sonia.
Yes, Sonia, please go on.
Yeah, the correct sentence will be a review on 25th 4/10 showed the patient's general health had improved. And her blood pressure dropped to 140 by 80 and she had lost 4 kg.
Very nice, Sonia. This is what is required on this platform. Active participation of all of you. I congratulate very much, Sonia, for your reply. And this is how the correct answer should look like. A review on 25th of April 2000 showed the patient's general health had improved, as Sonia told us, and her blood pressure had dropped to 140 by 85 and she had lost 4 kilograms. So this is how a correct sentence should look like. There should be had before every condition of the patient that we are describing, because all these conditions happened, or you can say took place in the past. So very nice, Susan, very nice, Sonia, for your participation. Let us come to another example of ours. And again, I request all of you to actively participate like Susan and Sonia have, and let us know as to how a correct sentence should look like. So let me show you the screens now. And this is our fourth example. She presented to me yesterday evening with abdominal pain, mostly on the left iliac fossa, and was since 24 hours. So can any of you let us know as to what's wrong with this sentence?
Had been, I can say, had been over the previous 24 hours.
Yes, very nice, Susan. But you know, on the last session, I told you something regarding for and since. So don't you think that there is something wrong with since also here, Susan?
Yes, had been for 24 hours, we can say.
Yes, yes, very correct, Susan. This is the most intricate thing that you caught in this sentence, yes, which most of the students fail to recognize. We always fail to recognize as to where for and where since and where over should be used. And I want to tell all of you that you, if you guys also confuse with regards to the usage of since, for and over, you can visit our last video, which was exclusively on these three terms, that is for, since and over. And I elaborated to you in very detail regarding the usage of these time phrase chronological terms, which most of the students while writing OET examinations confuse over. So Susan has contributed very healthily to all of us. And let us see as to how the correct sentence should look like. She presented to me yesterday evening with abdominal pain, mostly on the left iliac fossa, which had been occurring for the previous 24 hours, or Susan was also correct, over the 24 hours. Susan was very much correct when she told us the correct version of this sentence. So the first thing that I want to tell all of you is that all of you are doing very well. There is only a very little that is dragging you to qualify OET examinations, because the responses of all of you show that how much equipped you are with knowledge of English with regards to OET examination. So do not get demotivated. Be motivated, because all of you are performing extremely well. Let us look at one more example, and I will tell you as to what the correct version should be. She was admitted in Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital on 24 July 2008 because she collapsed at home. Now, this is a wrong sentence. The correct sentence should be, she was admitted in Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital on 24 July 2008 because she had collapsed at home. As simple as that. So do you see that these things are so simple, yet we commit mistakes while writing OET examination. Now, one more example. And here you go. And please see as to how an incorrect sentence has been given and what should the correct sentence look like. Now I request one of you, Dr. Irene, Ramya, Gavi, Salma, Muhammad, Asothai, to reply this time. If you are here on this platform, kindly reply to us as to what should the correct sentence look like. And please make sure that even if you reply wrong, I would appreciate you because your participation is important. Initially, she presented to me in July 2010 with a complaint of chest discomfort for 3 weeks. So what's wrong with this sentence? And can one of you catch as to what's wrong with this sentence and what should a correct sentence look like?
Hi, sir.
Hello, Ramya.
Can I answer?
Sonia, let Ramya answer first and then we will listen to your version. Ramya, can you tell us as to what's wrong with this?
Initially, she had presented to me. Initially,
okay.
She had.
Yes.
Presented to me in July 2010.
With a complaint of chest.
For 3 weeks.
Thank you very much, Ramya, for your contribution. Thank you very much. And I congratulate you also to participate. So, Sonia, you have to say with regards to this.
Yes, sir. My answer was same like she told.
Okay.
Initially, she had presented in July 2010 with a complaint of chest discomfort. So here I'm confused. For 3 weeks or for over the three? Like, I'm not understanding.
Okay. I'll answer to your question, Sonia, but it seems that you missed our last session. You can browse it on our YouTube channel with the same name and it's over there. I have very clearly and in detail, I have explained the usage of since, over and for. So Sonia, I want to repeat that since is used when your time is up, can appear on the calendar or clock. For example, since 2007, since February 2010. So these dates are on the calendar. But if you have to say that for the last few weeks, then last few weeks are not on the calendar. We do not know precisely when the week started. So here we will use for. When there is a duration of time, we will use for. When there is a point of time given, that is since 3 o'clock, since February, since Tuesday, then we will use since because we have a point of time. When we have a duration of time, then we will use for, like for the past 24 hours, for the past 1 month, for the past 3 weeks. But when there is a change in the patient's condition, we will use over. For example, the patient's condition deteriorated over the past few months. When there is a change in the condition of the patient, we will use over. For detailed information, you can browse through our last session. And this is how the correct version of this sentence should look like. Initially, she presented to me in July 2010 with a complaint of chest discomfort, which had been present for 3 weeks. So this is how the correct sentence should look like. Here, what you have to do is that first you recognize that which event happened first in the past? She presented to you, or chest pain happened first? Okay, Susan, I want to ask you one question. Did the chest pain happen first, or the patient presented?
Chest pain first.
Chest pain happened first. So we will make use of the condition of chest pain with head, because the chest pain happened first, then the patient presented to us. So the correct version should be that initially she presented to me in July 2010 with a complaint of chest discomfort, which had been present for 3 weeks. The second version can be, initially she presented to me in July 2006 with a complaint of chest comfort of 3 week duration. So initially she had presented to me is wrong, because she did not present to you before the chest discomfort. She presented to you only after the chest discomfort. So head is used with the event which happened first in the past, and then the second event is as it is presented. Now another example I want to show to all of you. And here we go. So this is our example. Mrs. Jones had taken microgynon 30 for the previous 5 years, but had stopped in May 2009. Now I believe that all of you can give me the correct answer, because now you clearly know which event happened first and which event took place later. Mrs. Jones had taken microgynon 30 for the previous 5 years, but had stopped in May 2009. And there is hint also given to you that past perfect is not used twice. Past perfect is used only once.
Sir, there is no had in the, but stopped in May 2009.
But stopped in May. Very good, Rana. Very nice. A very correct answer Ramya has given to us. This is how the correct answer should look like. Mrs. Jones had taken microgynon 30 for the previous 5 years, but stopped in May 2009. And here we have one more example. On rechecking at 10:45 p.m., her condition has further deteriorated and an ambulance was arranged for transfer to hospital. So the correct version of this sentence should be, on rechecking at 10:45 p.m., her condition had further deteriorated and an ambulance was arranged for transfer to hospital. So this is how the correct sentence should look like. Now let us come to another form, how to make subjects and verbs agree. How should the subjects and verbs agree? Now I want to tell you one thing, that we have two types of subjects. The first subject is the singular subject. The second subject is the plural subject. So what are singular subjects? Singular subjects are Manoj, Susan, Henry, Patrick, James, Mrs. Jones. These are singular subjects. And what are plural subjects? Plural subjects are doctors, nurses, the patients, the letters, the pages, papers. These are plural. So whenever we write a sentence, the subject and the verb should agree. Now, how would the subject and the verb would agree? The subject and the verb would agree when we know that with a singular subject, a plural verb is used. But with a plural subject, singular verb is used. So here we have first example over here. She and her friends are at the fair. She and her friends is at the fair is wrong. She and her friends are at the fair is correct. And what's the reason for this? When the subject of a sentence is composed of two or more nouns or pronouns connected by and. There should be an and between them. For example, the doctor and the nurse are at the hospital or is at the hospital. The doctor and the nurse are at the hospital. So whenever two subjects are connected by an and, what we will do is that we will make use of plural verb, that is are. Example number two, when two or more singular nouns or pronouns are connected by or nor, use a singular verb. Singular verb. And how? The book or the pen is in the drawer. The book or the pen is in the drawer. The doctor or the nurse is in the ICU. The doctor or the nurse is in the ICU. Now let us come to the third rule. When a compound subject contains both a singular and a plural noun or pronoun joined by or nor, the verb should agree with the part of the subject nearer to the verb. Nearer to the verb. For example, the boy or his friends run every day. So which one is nearer to the verb? Sonia, can you tell me that in our sentence, the boy or his friends run every day? What is the verb here?
So verb is run.
Run. And which subject is nearer to the run?
His friends.
Friends. So friends is singular or plural?
Sir, plural.
Plural, plural. So with plural subject, singular verb is placed. So we will not use runs. We will use run. In the second example, his friends or the boy runs every day. Now, Sonia, can you tell me which subject is nearer to the verb?
Sir, the boy, which is singular. And that's why we boy use plural.
Is singular. So we will use the plural verb. Very, very nice, all of you. Now, with this notion, I believe that you have understood these three rules to make the subject and the verb agree. The first rule is that when two nouns or pronouns are connected by and, we will use a plural verb, that is are. When two subjects are connected by or nor, singular verb is used. In case of a subject, that is singular and plural. In singular or plural subject are with or. Okay, I request all of you to unmute your. Each one of you. Please unmute yourself, everyone. Okay, fine. So these were the three rules. And so today we learned how to make use properly of the past perfect tense and how to make the subject and the verb agree. We will take forward this session in our next session on the next Sunday. With this notion, I wind up today's session. Thank you everyone for arriving here. And I hope that with each new session, you guys are learning something new. Please keep on revising these sessions by visiting the videos and sessions on our YouTube channel. Till then, I want to take a leave. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Manoj sir. This was another very useful session from Manoj sir. And thank you so much, Manoj sir, for providing this this much good session today. So guys, we are winding up for today, and if you guys have any kind of queries, you can just mail us on teacheracademy@gmail.com, or if you guys wants to enroll in our writing check or speaking check, you can just visit to our website, which is with the same name, www.teacheracademy.com. And guys, one useful information, please don't enroll in the writing at the last moment, because it's difficult for us to give you feedback in within a day. We at least need 2 days to give you feedback, because it is checked by a doctor or a nurse according to your profession, and then we forward it to our English teacher. So please give us some time, and if you guys have any other query, we are happy to help you out. Okay guys, with this notion, we are finishing today's session, and you can, if you have missed this session, you can just watch on our YouTube channel, which is with the same name, Teacher Academy. Okay, thank you guys for joining us today.
Thank you.